A very good evening to you. This is Cape Town TV News and I am Raymond Mbem. Tonight we focus on cities' safety and security frightened by the high figures of unlicensed drivers in the city. No arrests have been made yet for three child murder cases. And a Kraaifontein children's home is living on handouts. City of Cape Town Traffic Services spokeswoman Mel Lawrence says law enforcement officers have nabbed more than 26,000 unlicensed drivers on Cape Town's roads in just 3 months. Mel says this large number of unlicensed drivers was a cause for concern for the City Council. According to Mel, the unlicensed driver may know the working of a vehicle, but may not know the rules of the road which may lead to the accidents. She adds that the figure has officials so worried that the city's safety and security portfolio committee has placed it high on the agenda at meetings and it is exploring ways to tackle this danger on the road. Mel also vows that traffic services will continue their vigorous clampdown on unlicensed drivers. Police are still on a vigorous search for the suspects following the gruesome murder of three children around Cape Town within 2 days. An 8-year-old girl's body was found in bushes in Khayelitsha on Monday morning after the girl went missing on Sunday. In Philippi, a newborn baby was found in a plastic bag in a bin, and 24 hours later, another baby was found dumped in a bin on the corner of Parliament and Darling Street. Police spokesperson November Philander states that police are still investigating the cases and a case of concealment of birth is investigated. Police also confirmed that in another incident, a body of a newborn baby was found dumped in near Parliament in a busy central Cape Town yesterday afternoon. Bright Star Children's Home in Kraaifontein is still not registered with the Department of Social Welfare 12 years after it was opened to homeless children. Bright Star is home to 12 children who are infants and toddlers. The owner, Brenda Schuster, says they survive on foster care grant and donations and also get help from volunteers. CTV reporter Portia spoke to Brenda Schuster.
We started 12 years ago. We had a big crèche in Paro. Then we heard about Michaela, which is our oldest daughter. Mummy died and she's got an auntie, but at that stage the auntie didn't want to take her in because there was a little bit of problems. There is no money involved in this business. Please, these children receive a foster care grant, which is five of them. The other children don't receive any grant. My husband is working. I am staying with them 24/7. We pray a lot for people to help us because we do need it to survive. We do need it to also feed the children and to make sure that they've got everything that they need.
Social welfare official Millicent Khebe says it takes time for the application to be processed depending on the procedures and the types of services the applicant is offering to children. Millicent says there are channels to be followed and not everyone can be registered. That's all we've got for you this evening. Catch us again tomorrow, same time, same place, right here on the corner. From myself, Raymond Mbem, and the Cape Town TV News team, have a great evening.